type of match. Oh,
you're kidding
me. Oh, my God.
And Freak is at home in this.
Did you see how high the flames?
Oh, somebody is going to get burned. Burned alive in this match.
The hell is Teddy Long thinking?
And look at Kane. Look how sick that monster Kane is. A sadistic human being as I have ever seen in my life. He's actually at home right now. He's a sick, sadistic bastard.
Almost a smile on the face of the big red machine, Kane. We're about 6 feet from ringside, JBL, and you can feel how hot those flames are at this point in time. Imagine being inside the ring. And MVP perhaps looking for escape, but he can't do it.
Not only be inside the ring, understand also, oxygen is burned up by fire. The longer this match goes, the less oxygen these guys have to breathe in the middle of that ring.
MVP trying to beg out of the matchup. Kane wouldn't have it. Big boot to the face. And I guess, JBL, it's time to talk strategy. What is the strategy for this type of match?
Winning is a bonus. Survival. You want to not get burned. This is the craziest match I have ever heard of in my life.
And MVP whipped into the corner. Big boots to the face of Kane. And look at how close those flames are to the corner. Nearly lapping at the boots of MVP. Heading up to the top rope, but perhaps losing confidence a bit as he wasn't quite sure when the flames were going to come up just like that. So if MVP was on the top rope and the flames leaped up like that, perhaps he would have been burned and lost the matchup.
Should be hesitant. Oh, you have some type of trepidation. I'm sitting here 6 feet from him, and I'm hesitant.
Run. Kane working on MVP, the big red machine.
He's already trying. Look at him. He's already trying. Kane's already trying to stick his hand in the flames.
MVP whipped into the corner again by Kane. Clubbing blow to the back of the head.
You can't put this in perspective enough, Michael. Somebody is going to get burned by fire in this match.
MVP trying to crawl to the bottom rope, but as he does, he's crawling closer to the flames. Remember, there are no rules in the matchup, so there's no break here. MVP up to the top rope and slammed to the mat below. And look at how close MVP is to the flames that are surrounding the ring. This is such a unique matchup. It is so rare. There have only been three other matches, inferno matches, in the history of World Wrestling Entertainment. Extremely dangerous. And Kane putting MVP in the top rope. Now, if these flames leap up to that eight foot height here, MVP could be burned. Or if he's knocked off the top rope as well, John. And MVP realizing he's in trouble and knocking the big hit.
Good Lord.
Did you see how close those flames came to MVP? Lost body. Lateral press, but there are no pinfalls in this matchup. And the heat increases at least threefold whenever the flames leap into the air.
It's hard to believe what we're watching right now.
MVP, definitely the underdog in the matchup. And a boot to the jaw of Kane would be a monumental upset if MVP could pull it off here against the big red machine.
Look, MVP is in Kane's house right here.
Oh,
God.
Kane sitting up, and MVP realizing he's in deep, deep trouble.
And there's no place to go. Where are you going to go? You've got to stand there and fight this big monster.
And normally when things aren't going well, you can get out of the ring and take a breather. You can't really do that in this type of situation.
And you can barely breathe in there. That is 500 degrees.
Wow. The big red machine off the big boot, measuring MVP. And Mattel Montavious Porter, who has defeated Kane in a steel cage match in a street fight.
Nobody, Michael, deserves this kind of punishment. Nobody, not MVP, not anybody.
MVP going for the wide touch slam by Kane, as the flames seem to be an exclamation point to the choke slam. MVP in trouble as this sick, demented monster Kane releases the covering from the steel turnbuckle. Again, this is all completely legal. What the hell's Kane going to do with this? Look at him.
Oh, come on.
Kane with that turnbuckle covering actually put the fire out. And now he's trying to.
He's trying to get started. He puts Scott Fires out. Look at the goofy powers does this maniac have. Now, come on. Somebody stop him.
He's trying to burn Kane with a turnbuckle. I should say MVP with a turnbuckle cover. It's now on fire, and MVP luckily tosses out of the ring for hit for his safety.
The ropes on this side of the ring are melting.
MVP with the knees to the skull, going for a neck breaker. But now what MVP has to do is try to drag that carcass, that 300 pound carcass, toward the flames to catch it on fire. And there's a drop kick. And, well, perhaps this is the strategy, to use drop kicks to drive Kane closer to the flames. Oh, my God, Kane is moments away.
He's going to do it.
He's getting burned. Nobody hurt. MVP almost sliding into the fire. That close. That close.
MVP had to get burned off that.
It is an awe-inspiring sight to see this ring surrounded by these flames.
No!
And one of these men, ladies and gentlemen, will be burned tonight.
One of them's already burned, Michael. I don't understand it. You got to catch a guy on fire? What in the hell are we doing here on SmackDown? Well, Teddy Long has gone completely out of control.
Kane with that big clothesline to MVP, hoping to catch Montel Vontavious Porter on fire here tonight to win this Inferno match. The 300 pounder with a big clothesline to MVP. And Kane building momentum into the side slam.
This is ridiculous. This is sickening. Look at that sick monster. The hell is wrong with Kane?
Off that side slam, those flames shot high into the air again. Nearly engulfing the ring in flames.
It's not enough. MVP beat Kane twice, fair and square.
In a straight fight and in a steel cage, albeit by controversial fashion.
Why do they have to resort to something like this? Why would Teddy Long have to do this? MVP is a superstar.
That just seemed to up. To make Kane mad, MVP trying to get out of the ring.
Get out of there!
Going up to the top rope. MVP over the top rope and off the announce table. But he was managed to. Well, he leaped and then was pushed over the flames by the Big Red Machine.
He's not on fire.
No.
Come on. Oh, geez.
This matchup continues. Kane to the top rope. He's measuring MVP. The Big Red Machine taking MVP out. And looking over the announce table here, I can tell you, Kane was not burned either. His flames leaped high to the air, but Kane managed to clear the flames when he took out MVP. This matchup continues.
It's a 300-plus pound man coming off the top rope to the floor. Kane just missed the flames. Look at this.
Oh, my. And Kane missed the flames as well. Kane is just a hand away. MVP. Trying to keep himself from going into those flames and burning here.
And again, 500 degrees.
And there's a big boot off the skull of MVP by Kane.
Kane just smiled at the fire?
I think he did.
Kane just smiled at the fire.
You know Kane's history. Look at that sick smile.
Sick. Why would anybody do this to another human being?
Look at MVP trying to find cover underneath the ring.
Do you blame him?
No, not at all. And Kane with a right hand. A big right hand to MVP. The Big Red Machine stalking his prey. MVP to the steel step, trying to stay in the matchup. But Kane with a hand around his throat.
Come on, no.
Oh my God.
Stop it. Somebody
MVP
stop him.
No,
somebody stop him.
Look at this.
Somebody stop him.
MVP.
No.
Out of the flames.
No.
MVP.
Oh my God. Somebody stop it. Oh
MVP
my God.
MVP is on fire.
Somebody
MVP
stop
is
it.
MVP is on fire. This matchup's over. But MVP is on
he
fire.
He is on fire. Somebody put him out. For God's sake. Somebody
get help
back.
Out here. We need help out here. We need help. Oh my God. And finally some aid to MVP, who is completely. MVP has collapsed.
My somebody
God, get some help out here. MVP collapsing after being burned by
here
Kane.
Here's your winner, Kane.
You call that a winner? You call that freak a winner? I call it a damn travesty.
Yeah.
What in the hell? I hope you're proud of yourself, Teddy Long. Look at that. Look at what you've done. You've got a guy who might have third-degree burns on himself right now, and it's all Teddy Long's fault because he put him and he fed him to that damn monster game.